He will use the truth of God to hide behind, until the right moment. Sunday, July 7, 2013 at 5:35 p.m. My dearly beloved spouse, what does it matter if they shout at you or curse you in my name? What does it matter if all those who proclaim my most holy word and who remain steadfast in union with me, are shackled and beaten? Don't you know that my power is almighty and that I cannot be broken, even though they may break my bones? When a doctor fights to save the life of a man, whatever the cost, he will do everything possible to succeed. If he is interrupted by others, who try to stop him, if he is a dedicated doctor, he will ignore all protests and attempts to intervene with his ways, if he knows in his heart that he can and will save that life. And so he continues until all can see the fruits of his labor. He perseveres until that life is saved and then, when all is done, he will be greeted with love by the very people who, for whatever their reason, tried to interfere with his efforts to maintain life. And so all friction will have been forgotten. The same is true of this holy mission, promised by my Father to save the lives of his children in these, the final times, before my second coming. Expect interference with this mission, for were it not to attract such opposition, then you would surely know that my messages to you, now, could not be coming from your beloved Jesus. When the truth is declared, it is not easily accepted, though it be the word of God. Yet, when lies are presented, dressed up as the truth, they are more readily accepted, and in most cases, greeted with warm and welcoming arms. Be warned about the lies, which will be presented by my enemies, who declare themselves as my spokespersons. They will misguide you in many ways, for fear that you will catch them out in their deceit. They will spend their time associating with those known to the world as good and holy, pure servants, many of whom are now in heaven with me. By association they will be seen to be loyal disciples of such saints. Then they will repeat the truth of my teachings and this will confuse you. You will say, "But how can this be? This man speaks the truth. The cunning of the beast is beyond your comprehension, my beloved followers. He is careful never to reveal himself and so he hides behind the truth. When he is present in poor, deluded souls, he will use the truth of God to hide behind, until the right moment. Then, out will be poured obscenities against the word of God, but to many, this will not be clearly evident. Look behind the words, which will be carefully constructed and you will detect the lie. This is the kind of force, which God's children will have to contend with. The spirit of evil is like a dark cloud and when it has fully descended over humanity, it will become difficult to differentiate between good and evil. But I promise you that this cloud will lift and when the light of God shines through, you will see the wickedness in all its ugliness, as it is seen in the eyes of God. The fighting will continue amongst the people who pay allegiance to the one true God, as the evil one wreaks havoc amongst them. As this group splits into two, there are others for whom you must pray. They are those souls, who are so distant from God that they do not acknowledge Him, at any stage. They are my lost souls, for whom I dedicate this holy mission. When I save those who are completely lost, my intervention will also save the others, who are simply confused. Come, gather, all of you, before me, for my time is very soon. Let not one of you delay in praying for the souls of those who need your help the most. Your Jesus.